Okay, and welcome to the show, program, Drive Time, my ridiculously dumb talk show with just me, and it's March 11th, 2013, Monday morning, 8:54 in the a.m. Eastern Standard. Yesterday was daylight savings, so we lost an hour. I'm kind of all out of whack sleeping wise. Trying not to think about that. Just plug along as we were, as you were. I was gonna get a haircut yesterday. I did not. My hair is kind of out of control right now. I'm trying to do it in the mirror of my car as I'm driving a car. I'm driving a vehicle right now. The what you're looking at is the sky above me, and I'm fighting back a little bit of a cold. Hopefully it doesn't get any worse than this. It's annoying. But that's another thing. What can you do about that? Nothing. It's kind of a foggy morning. I think it's supposed to be okay weather-wise today and then rain tomorrow. I think it's supposed to be warm today. Fairly warm right now, but I think it's supposed to really get like in the 50s, high 50s, I heard. I actually looked at the weather yesterday. I think it said 58. So we'll see about that. Hopefully the rain holds off until later in the overnight. Okay, so this is the beginning of a kind of a big two-week period for me. Got a lot of things I want to get done. My lovely wife is she's out of the picture. To frame it like that, she's on for work. She's left. It's very lonely, and so you gotta fight the loneliness and just keep on going, keep on trucking. And I'm a little early for work here. It's okay. It's fine. Always, it seems like I'm constantly in between completely feeling overwhelmed and not giving a shit. And it's a much thinner line between those two feelings than you could ever imagine. And it's probably not normal. I probably shouldn't feel like I do. Probably be a little bit healthier if there was a little bit more give and take in that realm. Squirrel just darted past me, thinking I could have hit that squirrel and if things had been different. Right? That's life. So, I recorded a version of a parody version of the Ghostbusters theme last night at midnight on a whim. It wasn't a whim, it was a request. I think it went pretty well. I was worried I wouldn't be able to find an instrumental track of Roy Parker Jr.'s Ghostbusters theme song, but that was not difficult to find at all. Apparently 47,000 other people have wanted to either listen to that or do something with it, and so that's how many views it had on YouTube, which is kind of insane. I guess it's makes sense. I mean, it's a kind of an easy song to parody for whatever reason you want to use a parody. You want to write a parody song about the Ghostbusters theme. I guess you call it theme music. I don't know. It's kind of a song from the movie. It's not really a theme song. I guess we'll sort of, yeah. It's our theme song, I would say. I don't know why I didn't think it was, but yeah, I guess it is. Yeah, so my dog is doing well. He scared me yesterday. I got him some rawhide. He was like, It was bloody. He had like gnawed his gums a little bit on it. I had never seen that happen before, but I guess it's normal. He does that sometimes. Kind of got a little blood in his on his bone, on his rawhide bone. I also got him a Nyla bone. He didn't seem too interested in that. Chewed on for a little bit, but he knew there was some more meaty flavor up in the cupboard, so he was kind of not as much into that. He's a good dog. You gotta get up earlier to take care of him now that I'm a solo parent. It's a little difficult, but I don't mind. I passed a recycling bin this morning with nothing but a beautiful mix of Coke Classic, the red cans, and also like 20 ounce red bottles, like, I guess, and it was fucking filled. It didn't look like there was anything else in this whole recycling bin can outside of someone's house. Just almost like an even 50-50 mix of the red full-flavored cans and the 20-ounce full-sugar Coke regular classic bottles. I mean, just that's all you're drinking? Oh, my God. I'm not, look, people can drink what they want. Oh, what's in there? More mugs. I go by this thing every day and just mugs constantly. People throwing out mugs. Who wants to use mug? I guess it's not that big of a deal. You just wash it really good. But I don't know. Mugs are just seem like personal to me in a different kind of way than even a lot of other silverware and dishware. Like mugs would either be, you get mugs because it signifies something, or they're a gift, or someone, a friend gives it to you, or you take it from your parents' house. But just here every day, not every day, but every once in a while, there's this box of mugs appears. I don't know if people peddling in the used mug market. I don't trust those people. As far as I can spit.